Alright, Ancaster Fair, I want to share a Hollywood secret with you today. Come here, bud. But first, I have to tell you something about Twizzler. Hey, that's not very nice. As you know, we work in film. And a couple of years ago, we worked on a large movie, and we handled the main dog in the movie, the small white Bichon. But Twizzler also had a cameo in Priscilla, by Priscilla Presley. Now, I'd say that's pretty impressive for this young man here. But I want to share a secret with you about how we work with animals in Hollywood. So, sometimes when you watch movies, you see the dog looking off screen at the handler. This doesn't look very good, because it doesn't look like the dog's acting. So we have to change the... So we hide it in the actor's pocket, and then the dog would take cues while looking at the actor. But today I'm going to use his basketball. Because if you couldn't tell, it's his favorite thing in the world, and it's much easier for you to see. So this is the work away. Looking at the ball, listening to me.
So we're not going to do
it here? In the accessibility.
No, I'd go through this way. The gate's closed.
Yeah, this one here. Okay. Yeah.
So we give it one more try. Did you get it? Oh my gosh, Ancaster Fair, I love your energy.
We are going to bring somebody in. We are going to bring out six dice. We are going to bring out a dog. We are going to let this dog read that number. So we are going to welcome back to the stage everybody.
Sienna, you're doing this for me. I'm not taking the heat on this one.
You're making me do the hard part. Okay. There's so much joy here today. Oh my gosh, who's jumping the highest? Who's jumping? Oh, I'm thinking right there in the gray shirt. You want to be my helper? Oh yeah, come join us in here. Why don't you tell everyone your name?
Lizzie.
Let's give Lizzie a big round of applause for helping us out today. Come stand over here with me.
Hey, Lizzie, come over here for a quick second. Over with you for a second. So the way this is going to work is I'm going to first and foremost need you to pick a number between 1 and 6. Okay, so 7 is not between 1 and 6. But you know, if we're going to be honest with you folks, 6 out of 10 times somebody picks a number above 6. So we're going to give you a second try between 1 and 6. 5, perfect, okay. So number 5 is a number that we are going to get Pickles to read. And what we're going to do is we're going to get you to pick one more number and hide the number 5 beside it so we're not cheating. But Pickles does cheat, so we're going to have to cover her eyes later, too. So pick one more number between 1 and 6. 2. Okay, so number 5 is a number that our dog is going to find. So move side to side to make sure she can't see where Sienna's putting it. So look over your shoulder at the dog and then sort of block her on the right side of it. So every time she moves her head, so block it so she can't see. There you go. Now block it again.
...to train, but not nearly as hard as the next animal that we have out here. So the next animal is...
Gonna be tough getting these red cows moving. Gonna be Alyssa and Terry. Danielle and Molly. Rowan and Blair. Yeah. There's one in every crowd. There really is. Last call for Terry. Last call. Yeah, I thought he went to go get a different shirt because that one wasn't working. All right, Judge, it's up to you. Do we throw him out or we let him? He's here finally. We'll let him? All right, we'll let him run. All right, here we go. Alyssa and Terry, your cow's up on the board. You know who's going first. Here it is. It's number 5. I know. That's what you get for coming late to the party. But it's a different 5. It's the left 5 now.
Sienna is going to bring Lollipop back out in just a quick bit. I'm going to stand back here to give the animal center
stage.
So like Sienna did mention, these two dogs are flying to Elite on a custom stage in first class. Can you
imagine being on the plane here?
You
look over there. All right,
guys, out in 26. Are you guys ready
to see a dog and a cat on a scooter today?
Usually it takes
one or two just to wake
them
up a little bit.
Zeus.
Oh, yeah.
Well, they got number 5. That's one more than this fella got last time, so he's working his way up the ladder.
All right,
so that is pretty amazing. It's going to be Rowan and Blair.
put two at the same time and wanted to push up for 10 animals. And then not go
ahead. As you can see, Paulie lost her saddle at about 2 feet.
If you look around, you do notice we have a skateboard ramp over here. We got a skateboard ramp. We got a skateboard ramp. We got a little flat surface over here.
He's going to have to do a few more chores at home to be able to skateboard another saddle. All right, here we go.
Skateboard or scooter?
Cow's on the board. It's number two.
That's pretty awesome. Okay, you guys want to see a dog ride skateboards and scooters?
Locked on to number two.
Right, we're going to bring out the one, the only. Be deaf. So clap as loud as you can.
Up next is going to be Roland and Blair, then Kennedy and Shelby, then Richard and Brooklyn. Number two says, I don't think so, not quite yet.
Well, we got two right there. A lot of people are going to be on the street by the end of the day today.